On the last day of classes before holiday block leave, Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center students were already in vacation mode with plenty of holiday cheer, song, dance, and good food. Major General Tony Hale, the commanding general of the Army Intelligence Center of Excellence at Fort Huachuca, Arizona, stopped by to wish everyone happy holidays and to rest up for the return to school in January.
How y'all doing? Y'all ready for the Christmas break?
Yes, sir.
Everybody going somewhere for holiday block leave? Mostly?
Yes, sir.
Anybody staying around here? So I came by to make sure that no instructors were giving any mandatory homework over the holiday block leave. Okay? No mandatory homework over holiday block leave, okay?
Hale also thanked students for serving, explaining that a very small percentage of the American population joined the military.
Thank them for raising their right hands and supporting and defending the Constitution of the United States of America. And I think it's lost on our communities sometimes that less than 1% of the American population even meets the qualifications to join our military services. So I wanted to come out and visit the students, wish them a Merry Christmas and a Happy Holidays, to ensure that they knew that we needed them all to return in the new year to be part of the best team in the world.
Though most students will be leaving the Presidio of Monterey to spend time with their families, about 10% will stay behind, many opting to take tutoring classes and other activities.
Shooters, отлично, очень хорошо. Итак, и что мы делаем? Что нам легко? Что вам легко, мистер Абрахам?
One class is going to come back after the holidays and take their DLPT at the end of February. And if they score 3-3 or above, I will give them a four-day weekend. One student even said she was going to get a 4-4 on her DLPT. So specifically for her, if she gets that 4-4 or better, I'll give her a four-day weekend. And she was from a sister service. But I think it's good to, you know, incentivize, throw that carrot out there for the students to say, hey, you know, I want to meet the standard, but I want to do better than the standard. And I think that's great.
Hale also made a point to explain what it means to be an intelligence linguist.
In some cases, some of our military soldiers, some of our soldiers, sailors, airmen, and marine, go to assignments that need that higher level of proficiency in their language. As an example, someone going to the National Security Agency that's doing a national level mission probably needs to be 2+, 2+, or higher to go and do their job to the standard that our nation needs. Some soldiers maybe would be okay with a 2-2 standard. So we're looking at how we're going to meet that 2+, 2+ standard. Maybe not for every soldier or sailor, airman, or marine, but for those that are going to those critical assignments, absolutely. And then what I think you'll see is we evolve to large-scale combat operations, working in a multi-domain environment. We're going to focus on our peer and near-peer adversary languages. So think Chinese, think Russian. A senior officer visits, you know, and I kind of am just engaged with the kids. It makes them see that I'm a human being. And I call everybody kids that, you know, don't outrank me, really. The students energize me to do things and to make our services better. And I think that it's important for them to see a human being as well as a senior leader.